guys, welcome back to my channel. So I was ready to do a hair tutorial with my flat iron and I got a good look at it and I thought, gross, that is disgusting. I would never want to show people what that looked like. But then I thought maybe other people out there might have a flat iron that or a curling iron that might have the same problem. So one of the problems I face when doing my hair, whether it be with a flat iron, a curling iron, or anything that uses heat that goes onto the hair, I get buildup on my curling iron and my flat iron and never really noticed it, which is kind of weird and gross. Never really noticed how bad it was until I decided to start making these videos. And so I'm gonna show you how bad it is. It's so embarrassing, but hold on just a second. Here it goes. Okay, I'm back. This is it. It's really disgusting. But if you look at it, you know, it obviously hasn't been cleaned in a very long time. But I'm gonna show you how to get it cleaned today. And hopefully that you can use this at home, this little hack at home. So here we go. Okay, so for the purposes of this video, I'm gonna show you exactly what I use. So I'm gonna use a little bit of lemon juice. The fresher the better. Right now we're not in lemon season right now. I mean, they're not even big enough to pick yet. So we use some of the leftover lemon juice that we've juiced from previous lemon harvest. Probably later in this channel I might start showing you guys what we grow in our garden and stuff like that. But anyways, fresher the better. And so I just pour some in the bowl. I don't think there's any like certain amount you need to use. And then I also take baking soda and I pour baking soda in there. And if you hear that, I don't know if you can hear that at all. It starts to kind of sizzle. I don't know if you can hear that. But anyways, I don't know if you can even, there you go, you can see it a little bit. It's kind of bright, but you can see it. But anyways, and then I'm gonna use that mixture on the curling iron, or on the flat iron, and hopefully it'll take the hairspray off of it. All right, guys, so this is my absolutely disgusting flat iron. So I'm going to use that mixture that we just made to try to get off all of the gross buildup from the hairspray that has been used over time. One thing that I probably would recommend, I don't know how it got this bad, but one thing I would recommend is when you are using your flat iron, not to spray a ton of hairspray on your hair before you curl your hair. So anyways, that's the only time I use the hairspray. When I'm flat ironing my hair straight, I don't use anything, but other than maybe a heat protectant. But here's the straightening iron. So we're gonna go ahead and try to clean it. So here's the mixture of the lemon and baking soda that we just made. It, as you can see, it's kind of not foaming anymore, but it definitely will start but it should still work even though it's not foaming. You probably would want to use it right away, but I kind of let it sit out a little bit. So we're gonna try it out and see what happens. Before we get started, one other thing that I wanted to say is please make sure that your curling iron or your flat iron is completely cooled off, because if you don't, I know this is crazy that I feel like I have to say this, but if you don't, you will get burnt. It's not a good idea, it doesn't feel good. Turn your curling iron off or your flat iron. All right, here we go. Okay, so the first thing that I do is I take just a regular regular washcloth, or any type of maybe rag that you might use. So I take just any type of cloth and I will dip this in here in the solution. made kind of a mess. Be careful, because it is messy. And I will take this and I will hold it over the curling, over the flat iron, which apparently I cannot say, even though that's what I'm holding in my hand. And I will let that sit for about 15 minutes or so, and then we will come back and we will see what it looks like. See you in 15 minutes. Okay, so as I was kind of curious, I came back in a few minutes and I just looked, it was about 5 minutes later, and just looked, and as you can see, I know that's disgusting, but as you can see, it's starting to come off. And I've just let it sit there, and so I know it's working. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave it back on the counter, and I'll come back in another 10 minutes, like I said before. Okay, so now we've come back, and I am going to look at what we have. See if you'll see that it's starting to come off. In chunks. You can just pull it off. It's kind of gross, but it just comes right off. Now I'm going to go ahead and scrape the rest of that buildup. You might want to get something that's like a scraper or something to get all of it off. But I'm going to go ahead and scrape this now and we'll come back and see what it looks like. Alright, the other thing I did was I took this brush, and it's kind of like a thicker, it's not a brush, it's like a sponge, and it's a little bit, it's got like, it's like a scrubby, and I took it with some hot water, and I just scrubbed everything down, and now there it goes. It didn't look like that before. Anyways, I hope that this helped, and if you have any other ideas on how to clean your curling irons or straightening irons a little bit easier, please leave comments in the below, and if you will like and subscribe, I would appreciate it. Have a great day.